Hi children, we stopped the second audio where the swallow decides to stay with the happy prince. Now we continue. All the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange lands. Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things. But more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. Rather than telling me about the tales of strange lands, tell me about what my people undergo. My city, fly over my city and tell me what you see there. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. White faces because no blood circulation, pale, understand, pale face of starving children looking out listlessly. Listlessly means no energy at all at the black streets. Under the archway of the bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. How hungry we are, they said. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I am covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off, leaf by leaf, and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and grey. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's faces grew rosier and they laughed and played in the street. We have bread now, they cried. So they got help from that, right? When the gold was in the statue, it didn't help anyone. These leaves of gold helped the poor children. Then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. The streets looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and the little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. So whole weather changed. From the description, it's very clear how cold it would have been. Scarlet means red color. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder, but he would not leave the prince. He loved him too well. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So this weather did not suit the swallow at all, but still he did not leave the happy prince. Somehow he tried to manage himself, but at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. Goodbye, dear prince, he murmured. Will you let me kiss your hand? I'm glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little swallow, said the prince. You have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on the lips, for I love you. It is not to Egypt that I am going, said the swallow. I am going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not? And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, as if something had broken. The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right in two. We always use, there's a phrase like heartbroken. So like that, the leaden heart broke into two. It certainly was a dreadful hard frost. So whether it was the impact of the frost or the prince's heart broke at the death of the swallow, it can be interpreted in both ways, right? Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in company with the town councillors. As they passed the column, he looked up at the statue. Dear me, how shabby the happy prince looks, he said. How shabby indeed, cried the town councillors, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. The ruby has fallen out of his sword. His eyes are gone and he's golden no longer, said the mayor. In fact, he's little better than a beggar. Little better than a beggar, said the town councillors. What does it show? The town councillors repeating whatever the mayor says. They don't have an individuality of their own. They just imitate or mimic or do whatever the mayor says, that's all. They don't have a voice. They don't express their own opinion. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet, continued the mayor. We must really issue a proclamation that birds are not to be allowed to die here. And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. So they pulled down the statue of the happy prince. As he is no longer beautiful, he is no longer useful, said the art professor at the university. So art professor, they always look at the beautiful aspect of things, right? Oh, he's no longer beautiful, so he's no longer useful. Then they melted the statue in the furnace. What a strange thing, said the overseer. Overseer is a supervisor of the workmen and the foundry. Foundry is a workshop, factory for casting metal. This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace. We must throw it away. So they threw it in the dust heap where the dead swallow was also lying. So look at that. It's a coincidence. They threw the heart also where the dead swallow was lying. Now look at the rest of it. It's given in italics, written in italics. Bring me the two most precious things in the city, said God to one of his angels. And the angel brought him the leaden heart and the dead bird. You have rightly chosen, said God. For in my garden of paradise, this little bird shall sing forevermore. And in my city of gold, the happy prince shall praise me. Now, that is a message. God considers them as very, very precious. Okay, that is the story, children. Thank you.